This week on the Internet Cafe, buy it online. Meet Jessica Adelson, editor of NetGuide and online shopping guru. The hot ticket in cyber shopping is the online auction. We'll show you one. Peter Graniff has a great job. He's the wine taster for the Virtual Vineyards website. And if you're looking for the latest high-tech gadget, be sure to stop by compare.net to do your comparison shopping. Plus, never have to talk to a car salesman again. Just log on to autovitel.com. Buying it online this week at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is brought to you by Z Auction, the live online shopping experience. Additional funding from PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with PC and Mac products, toll-free technical support, and overnight delivery. And by Windows Magazine, delivering desktop, enterprise, and internet computing news, reviews, features, and how-tos for a Windows world, because the world runs on Windows. Additional funding from SoftSource Incorporated, publishers of Pro One Software, educational software for young adults.
So we're talking about shopping online, and I hope that you don't mind this, but I mean, women do a lot of shopping, right? I think women are better shoppers than men. So I want to defer to you first. What did you think about the online
shopping? Well, we could talk about that topic, but I'm not sure if we're better. We just shop differently.
More.
We like to look.
Yeah. All right, so who are you going to talk to tonight about online shopping?
We're going to talk about actually two very interesting sites. One is NetGuide, which is a good overview. If you've never done online shopping, this is a great place to sort of get some hints on some of the really good sites. And also, I'm going to look at AutoBuyTel, which is taking the gnarly part of car buying out of the equation. So that's going to be good.
And you're looking at, an auction site online, right?
Yeah.
That's becoming real popular.
Yeah, Z Auction. And I'm not convinced about this whole buying online because I like to feel and touch things.
Yeah,
but I've been told...
Well, if you can get a bargain.
Well, I've been told that there's a real kind of a zing there, a real thrill. It's kind of almost, I don't want to say online gambling, but it's a little bit like that. You know, there's some real bargains. People get real excited, so we're going to check it out.
And wine buying, right?
Wine buying, yeah. Now, I need a little lesson in wine buying, so this might be a good first step for me.
All right, I'm going to look at a guy who runs a site called compare.net, which is really great to find out what you ought to be buying, even if you're buying in the real world, but you go to the net to sort of figure out what the best purchase is.
Oh.
All right, so this is Shopping Online tonight at the Internet Cafe.
You know, Jessica, I always thought that I was the expert shopper. I mean, I knew exactly where I needed to get all the stuff I wanted. And now all of a sudden the online experience comes, and I'm like a kid. I have, you know, no idea where to go. And you've got a website, NetGuide, and part of the NetGuide site has information about shopping for those of us who get a little overwhelmed by the online shopping experience. What are some of the things that you have to talk about at that site?
Well, first of all, it's the shopping guide, so it's one of the sections on NetGuide, and it's a great starting point for someone who's just starting to get online and wants to dabble in shopping and isn't sure where to begin. So what we do to begin with is we break it up into categories. So we make the experience easier to browse. So you're interested in flowers, gifts, entertainment, apparel. We break it up into sensible categories so you can go in and poke around. And in those categories, we tell you, here are some tips. Here is how you go about finding the best sites to find books, the best sites to buy music, the best sites to do different kinds of things online. And you know, there's so much you can do online, it can get overwhelming.
I liked your tips. You've got some how-tos, some of the things that you need to know about, like how to use a shopping basket and those types of things. Now, the online experience is different from shopping in catalogs or going into a shop, for example. What do you think the benefits are? What is what are the best things about the online experience?
Well, I think one of the best things is you can use robots to make the experience really, really easy for you. If you're someone who doesn't want to deal with the stores and you know what you're looking for, you're looking for something specific, like a book by a certain author, or certain music, or you want to find something rare that's hard to find, you can use the internet, a robot on the internet, type in what you're looking for, and it can bring back a ton of results, and it can even tell you the cheapest places you can find those things.
So I can save time on getting stuff that I really know what I'm looking for.
Exactly. And it's also save you time, it could also save you money, because it tell you the cheapest places to find it also.
So now what if I wanted to, I mean, does it help me in terms of community, in terms of saying, you know, if I really like this kind of a book, will it give me some hints on other books that I might be interested in, or is that there yet?
Yeah, it's actually there. There's a company called Firefly. It's an agent technology, and what agents can let you do is it learns your behavior. It learns that Jane likes to read Kurt Vonnegut, therefore a lot of other people who like to read Kurt Vonnegut also like to read Doug Adams. so it'll make a record.
To collect information.
Exactly.
Now, that leads me to another question. What about security? I mean, if they're asking or finding out so much information about my behavior, it's kind of scary to me that there's so much information. What are the pitfalls, associated with that?
Privacy is definitely an issue online, and you have to be careful about who you're giving that information to and that you feel comfortable with that vendor, and that there's a lot of notification on that site that says they're not going to give that information away, that it's only for the purpose of this product and selling, and they're not going to market to it and sell that information. Privacy is a big issue on the internet. You have to be very careful when you're shopping that you're wary of that.
So there's lots more information at NetGuide to show us some of the pitfalls and some of the things we need to know about the online
experience. You should look at the sites, make sure that they're real, that they exist, that there's information about them, maybe an address, a phone number, so that you know it's not a fake store, that it's a real store.
Right.
And because you can masquerade online just like you can offline. So that's something else you should look out for.
So does the Better Business Bureau, are they going to help me on proving that these guys are in business, or are there some other things that I can look for?
The Better Business Bureau is definitely a place you can always turn to. You can always look at the little key on the bottom of your site for Netscape and make sure the key is a solid key. That'll tell you it's a secure transaction, so that when you send information over that it's going through secure.
Right.
There's a lot of tips you can look out for, and we give you all that information on NetGuide.
A smart shopper is somebody who really understands the marketplace and knows what's out there. That's not always easy to do in the real world. It's in fact easier to do in the world of the internet. So a couple of guys got the very clever idea of building a website to help you comparison shop. And one of the guys who founded one called Compare.net is here in the cafe tonight. John, how you doing?
Pretty good. How are you?
All right. I looked at Compare.net, and it's sort of like kind of a search engine for shoppers in a way. It helps you find what you're looking for.
Yeah, it's something like that. Compare.net is really the number one source for free and comprehensive consumer product research on the web.
There's a commercial right there.
There it is.
All right, let me ask you what goes on there. First of all, when I took a look at it, obviously I'm concerned about the validity of the sources. Where do you get your information about describing these products?
Well, we have about 25 employees, and the lion's share of them are actually building the content for us.
So you're not just stealing this from brochures, have an editorial process.
Yeah, we really think that's important, because one of the things we do is standardize the information so that you can really compare brand by brand,
right,
meaningfully. So we feel like we have to have the people in-house both creating the content and maintaining it.
And in this area, I know you have a lot of electronic stuff and computers and so on, in which the information is changing so quickly. That's one of the problems. Can you really keep up so that I'm confident the information you've got there is current?
Yeah, well, it's one of our major purposes. I agree with you. One of the hardest things for a consumer is to know what's out there.
Today.
So what we do, one of the major things we do is provide an education for consumers. What are the latest features? What are the trends? And really enable people to make informed buying decisions.
All right, now let's go through a sample search. Let's say we go onto your website right now, and I'm looking for, say, a palm top organizer or something like that. What's the process of finding out comparative information?
Well, you would go to our electronics section. You would choose electronic organizers.
Mm-hmm.
On that page, first you would read our tips on buying, and that's the education I was referring to.
Well, what do you mean by tips?
Well, we tell you, hey, these are the hot features in PDA and the electronic organizer market.
Okay, so check out the memory or check out the connectability or whatever
right,
it is.
PC link, different types of things.
Okay.
We try to help people find the right features for them. Then we give them a list of all of the features that are relevant to shopping for an electronic organizer.
Mm-hmm.
And based on the knowledge that you gained reading our tips, you choose the ones that are relevant.
All right,
to
so I fill in a check on a bunch of boxes and stuff, and I say, show me what the comparisons are between these.
Exactly, and we have information.
And you give me kind of like a grid, and yes, it has it, no, it doesn't, that kind of stuff.
Right, well, you can compare them model side by side, you can look at them in detail, and we have information on every brand and every model out there. So we really give you a snapshot of the market.
Now, one of the things I know a lot of people do shopping research online, and what I like to do is get kind of qualitative stuff. Read a posting by some guy who bought this thing and liked it or didn't. Is that kind of information available?
We do have a bulletin board where users sound off about models they have, the brands they've shopped for. We also have links to reviews from our site. So, yeah, we try to give people the qualitative reviews as well.
Now, I take it this is for more than just online shopping, though, right? I mean, if I want to walk into a physical store and buy something, I could still do my research at Compare.net?
That's why we built it. Everyone's had this problem. You walk into a retailer, you know you need to buy a stereo receiver, for example, and there's a whole wall of receivers. You don't know much about receivers. You haven't bought one for 8 years. We give people the baseline education to go in there and make informed buying decisions.
Now, how deep does this go? I mean, there's a lot of stuff to buy in the world. How many product categories? What goes on inside the site?
We have seven general product categories: automotive, electronics, home appliances, sports and leisure, computer peripheral equipment, and software.
Memorize them all.
I do. I mean, it's my business.
All right.
And what we're trying to do is provide consumers access to information on any type of considered purchase. And what we mean by that is purchases where there's a risk in making the wrong decision, where you need education so that you know, you know, you find the product that's right for you.
I don't have to pay for the service, do I?
Absolutely free.
All right, and it's called compare.net.
That's right.
All right, thanks, John.
Thank you.
Colin, you're from Z Auction, and that's one of the kind of first, I think, online auction sites or something along there.
Yeah, well, thanks for having me, Andrew, first of all. But yeah, we were one of the premier auction sites.
Okay, now let me just step back for 1 minute.
Sure.
My idea of an auction, my parents had an antique store when I was a kid. We used to go to these antique auctions. This guy up there, 5, 25, 35, 45, yeah. You know, that's
right,
an auction.
Exactly.
Now, what is an online auction?
Well, the auction process is basically the same. Basically, for example, we put up 10 units of a particular computer product.
Mm-hmm. And you guys specialize in mainly
computers and electronics. Yeah,
okay.
We're doing some things in travel products as well, cruises and things like that.
Oh, really? Oh, so it's not just technology.
No.
Okay.
But technology is our focus.
Okay.
But for example, if you wanted to bid on a computer part, we'd start the bidding at $1, and there'd be 10 pieces available, and you bid it up, and at the end of the auction, it closes, just like a regular auction.
Now, is there actually someone out there who's, you know, rattling off prices, or
no?
Is
it's
all
the system is all interactive, so you'll see what bids are out there. You go ahead, you can make comments on the site,
and
if
place
you drop
your bid.
Yeah, place your bid. If you get dropped off, the system will interactively email you and say, hey, Andrew, you need to raise your bid
Get
back
in the fight. Oh, it'll actually tell you.
Oh, absolutely. It's all interactive, yeah.
So how long does an auction like this actually last? I mean, regular auctions last a matter of minutes.
We're running 3 times a week.
Okay.
So, for example, if we close an auction on Wednesday and we open one on Wednesday, it'll close on a Friday and we'll open
one up. So it's about 48 hours,
yeah, exactly,
72
hours,
something like that.
Yeah, and we expect to move up to 5 per week.
Okay.
Pretty shortly.
Now, I looked at this last night, and I have to say, it's kind of addicting, especially if you're kind of a technology buff or an equipment, you know, fan.
Sure.
I got sucked into. I saw these 21-inch Nokia monitors, big computer monitors.
Yeah.
I was sitting at my computer, and I thought, God, you know,
this
might be kind of a fun thing. You find people get sucked in, or
sure. I mean, when we looked at this initially, we saw all these online catalog businesses, but there was no fun, there was no interactivity.
Right.
So that's what we try to create.
Okay.
And people get into it, they're addicted, we get a lot of repeat business. And,
right. Now, can you really find deals? I mean, these monitors started at a very low price.
Right.
By the time I read some of the bids that had been placed, you know, they were up there. And
I
think you kind of had to know, you had to know what the real value of it is. But are there deals?
Absolutely. The format allows. The auction format is truly a new format in internet commerce, in the sense that it's bridging the wholesalers with the retail customer.
So it's putting them together.
Yeah, you're taking out a middleman.
Right.
So from that perspective, people are getting tremendous deals.
So I mean, can you save up to 25%, 30%?
I'll give you an example. We had some 21-inch monitors that sold for $26.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, now,
so,
see, that was a better deal than the
better
ones
deal.
I saw.
Yeah, you just got to keep your eyes open and look for the smarter
deals.
Right.
Now, I also see that there's some competition going on among auctioneers or people who are trying to buy. I notice you can post little comments, and people get kind of competitive in there, like, you know, here's my bid, take that, the rest of you.
Yeah, exactly. And we encourage that.
Encourage that.
Absolutely. I mean, part of the whole internet thing is to facilitate a transfer of some information.
Okay.
So if people can give information, as long as they don't post nasty comments and things like that, we're okay with it.
Right. Okay, now for the future of online auctions, obviously computer stuff is what's going on right now. That's what a lot of the audience wants.
Sure.
Where do you see the future of this kind of thing going?
Well, I don't see any limit, frankly.
Okay.
I think
you said cruises was
cruises, another. Yeah. I think any product really that lends itself to the format potentially could be doable, is viable.
Okay, now do you think we'll get back to antiques online, or is that just too arcane?
Absolutely. You know, the trick is fulfillment and trust within the company itself.
Right.
You know, do you trust who you're buying from? Are you going to get the genuine product?
Right.
So,
and
you know,
that's hopefully what you guys are
delivering.
That's
what we do, yeah.
Okay. Well, thanks a lot, Colin.
Oh, appreciate it.
So, Mark, with car buying has been a nightmare for me in the past, and now we have the ability to get lots of information online. And you've got a website called AutoBuyTel, which is something slightly different from typically getting information. There's a lot more there. What right. is AutoBuyTel trying to do for the car buyer?
AutoBuyTel was founded chiefly because of a problem in the distribution of cars. Right? Car buying has not changed in 100 years in the United States. 31% of the price of every car is in its distribution. The internet works perfectly in a complex configuration process like a car purchase,
right?
Okay, where it's real value added and can lower the cost of distributing the car, and that's where AutoBuyTel plays in the internet space.
So if I was a consumer and I went to AutoBuyTel, I knew which car I wanted to buy. Where are you going to take me from there?
You don't even have to know what kind of car you want to buy when you first get to AutoBuyTel, because we have all of the information on every car that's for sale in the United States. Every car that you can get, you can go and you can get information on its specifications, and more importantly, the dealer invoice price.
Mm-hmm.
So that when you finally get through the dealer to the dealer, which you do by filling out a purchase request, very specifically enumerating exactly what you want in the car. And remember, you have all the information on the site. You can even do head-to-head comparisons on different models you're looking at.
So I've got all the options that I've specified.
Every single thing, soup to nuts, including, you know, different color choices, first and second color choice, things like that. It gets zapped to the dealer, who then comes back to you on the phone within 24 hours with a firm price. Okay? You have all the information you need to know whether or not that's a fair price.
So you've taken the kind of the nightmare for me, which in my purchase experience, it's been, you know, finally figure out which car I want. I'm really excited to get it. I walk in and I say, okay, I want to buy the car. What's your price? And I'm there for hours. And so you've shortened my personal experience down significantly.
Well, Jane, some people
well.
Like spending 15 hours in car dealerships talking
don't.
To car dealers, but most people don't. And that's what we do. As a matter of fact, we make sure all the dealers, we now have 2,500 throughout the United States, are contractually bound to get you in and out of the dealership within 1 hour after you've decided to make the buy.
Now that's for new cars. What if I wanted to buy a used car?
The used car, it works a slightly different way. Our used cars, every used car in our system, okay, we've now had, since we've relaunched about 2.5 months ago now, we've had 35,000 cars go through the system. Okay? Keep in mind our used car superstore has 1,000 cars. We've had 35,000 go through in 10 weeks.
Wow.
All right. Each one of those cars goes through 135-point inspection. Okay, has a 3-month, 3,000-mile warranty.
So you're warranting the product, or is it
the dealer's
dealer?
Warranty okay. the product themselves. And it's home and away, so any AutoBuyTel dealer will service if it breaks down outside of your local area.
So I can buy a used car using your service as well. And can I finance it too? I mean, is there financing available for new
financing
and used?
Financing is available, depending, no matter what your credit grade is. We have Chase Manhattan Bank, we have KeyBank, we have GE Capital for leasing, we have Triad all
so
online.
So I've got choices as well. Now, let me ask you, just in terms of the industry overall, I mean, the auto industry is huge, and this is sort of a real departure for the auto industry to be using the internet, not just for a manufacturer that has a website that shows its cars, but now we're talking about actually the purchase experience for the
right.
consumer.
Right.
How many people do you think are actually using the internet to buy or at least be involved in some part of that purchase decision?
The manufacturers think now that between 20% and 30%, which is about what we think also, of the people now use some part of the internet and some part of their purchasing experience. That number should increase at 75-80% easily. As a matter of fact, there's a quote from one of the big three executives that said that one day the last dumb car buyer is going to come walking through our door. This is a published quotation from somebody from Chrysler, and they're right. I mean, with all the information that's available on the internet, instantaneously for anyone who just wants to go on and look, it doesn't make any sense not to use the internet when you're buying something as expensive as a car.
Peter, you are the proprietor of Virtual Vineyards, which I think was surely one of the first online wine stores. Mm-hmm. And I have to admit, I am not a wine connoisseur. My idea in the past of a good wine was probably ripping the lid off a screw
yeah.
cap, some Boone's Farm, something like that.
Pop top.
Exactly. Now, my first perception, you know, the internet, you sort of think computer savvy, almost computer geek.
Mm-hmm.
Are computer geeks buying fine wines online?
Yes, they are.
They are. Okay.
But in the first, well, we've been out there since January 95. So that first year, a lot of technical people, a lot of engineers.
Right, back in the dark ages of the internet.
A lot of very computer savvy individuals.
Okay.
But now, of course, the customer base is much broader.
Mm-hmm.
And as the internet becomes mainstream, it's only becoming more so.
Okay, so now, a novice like me goes on, what kind of information am I going to find on your site that I maybe couldn't get going into the local whiskey
right.
jug, wine jug
right.
shop?
Right. Well, depending on what part of the country you're in,
mm-hmm.
Your selection is more or less limited. In California, as an example,
mm-hmm.
there are actually over 900 wineries, which
wow.
is something most consumers don't realize.
Okay. And you're based in California.
We're based right here in California.
Okay.
Plus, I have been a professional buyer in the wine business for nearly 20 years.
Oh, okay.
So I know a lot of these producers.
Mm-hmm.
Many of them are very small. Of that 900, at least half are 5,000 case range, which is very small in the context of the wine business.
Okay.
So first of all, we offer an interesting selection that's
mm-hmm.
very carefully selected.
Okay.
Everything is tasted prior to making a decision whether to present it or not.
Do you actually taste these yourself?
That's an important part of my job.
Okay.
Everyone envies that part of my job.
I was
going
to say, does drinking and the internet mix? That's the,
right.
that's
well,
the question.
Drinking and driving, drinking and the internet, the bad news is that I actually have to spit as part of this evaluation. That really puts people off. But then when you look at the presentation and the selections, the depth of information that surrounds each selection
mm-hmm.
is much greater than you would get in a typical or conventional retail setting.
Okay.
We explain the wine, we describe the wine, we give you background on the producer, we often make pairings, food pairing suggestions,
okay.
And many of those are actually tied to the specialty foods portfolio as well.
So you're not only offering wine,
no,
but you're offering
no,
specialty foods.
Carefully selected gourmet and specialty foods, and also some accessories too.
Okay.
Glassware, things like that, that are related to the enjoyment and the use of the food products and enjoyment of
so
wine.
So I could go on there and really impress my girlfriend with a fancy dinner and show up with the
I
whole
think
thing
so.
There.
I okay. think so. There's also question and answer feature of the site as well. Ask the Cork Dork.
Oh, I
so.
Saw that. Actually, I identified when I saw the name Cork Dork.
Right.
I thought, that's probably me.
Well,
so.
You'd be surprised how many email questions we've got from people who are in exactly that situation.
Really?
I'm planning a great dinner. It's got to be a special occasion. I've got everything else picked out. Help me select the wine. Help me plan the menu.
Right.
Or I have an old bottle of something that was given to me, or I bought it at auctioners
mm-hmm.
in my cellar.
Mm-hmm.
Help me figure out what to do with this. Is it ready to drink? Is it not?
And the Cork Dork is the one who will answer that.
And the Cork Dork answers all those questions.
Right. Okay, now that actually brings up a point. I also saw that you guys offer a wine course that actually comes with a
yes.
selection of wines.
Yes.
How does that work?
Well, I would like to think that Virtual Vineyards is part education and part just a great retail place to purchase
mm-hmm.
fine wines. But the educational component is very important. We working with Digital Think, which is a small startup company in San Francisco.
Online education company.
Precisely.
I've heard of them.
They're completely committed to web-based education.
Okay.
They do a great job of designing the process that the student goes through
okay.
using
and you,
the
and,
internet.
And you guys actually send us a case
came
of
to
wine,
us,
is it?
Well, they came to us and said, mm-hmm. would you help us design a course? Because
okay.
Tim Gazer and I, who do all the wine writing for Virtual Vineyards, both have a lot of experience teaching. And so we put together an education, a course, as an introduction to wine tasting, and then as an adjunct to that, there's a mixed case of wine available at Virtual Vineyards
Great.
To help you as you go through the course.
Well, I'm going to go order this case of wine and try it out. I'll let you know how it comes
Please
out.
Please do. Let me know.
Great.
Let me know.
Well, I don't know what you thought, but, a lot of the experts on the net are saying online shopping, e-commerce is really what the killer app on the net's going to be. So this is
mm-hmm.
probably very important stuff we talked about tonight. So what did you think, though, about the sites you saw, like Autobuy Television?
Well, I like the concept of getting rid of that nasty experience buying
not having
negotiating.
To deal with a car floor
right.
salesman.
So that was really good.
Yeah.
I think that the NetGuide was really interesting in that it showed you some of the hot sites. So if you haven't thought about doing online shopping
mm-hmm.
before, it's a great introduction to some of the places you can
yeah.
save time.
And are you going to go to an online auction now?
Well, buying wine online was okay. Wine online was
online.
Okay, but Z Auction really had a zing to it. It was kind of like gambling when you're suddenly thinking, wow, I almost could win something big here.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that was kind of like
or
that,
lose.
You know? Or well, lose. But
yeah.
You're not going to lose there. Chances are you're going to win a lot of really good equipment at some good prices.
Yeah.
So it was good.
The thing I liked about the guy I talked to at compare.net is it's hard to get information when you're out there shopping in the real world. This is really to help you when you walk into the store, to walk in and be an intelligent shopper so you can talk intelligently to the salesman and really get the best deal on what you want. So I think that's a very good use of the net. Mm-hmm. All right, that's online shopping. We'll see you here again next week at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is brought to you by Z-Auction, the live online shopping experience. Additional funding from PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with PC and Mac products, toll-free technical support, and overnight delivery. And by Windows Magazine, delivering desktop, enterprise, and internet computing news, reviews, features, and how-tos for a Windows world, because the world runs on Windows. Additional funding from SoftSource Incorporated, publishers of Pro One Software, educational software for young adults. To purchase a videotape copy of today's program, call toll-free 1-888-310-7850. Please specify the show number and the topic.